Volodymyr Zelensky has lashed out at NATO, saying it's absurd no timeframe's been given for Ukraine to join the military alliance. NATO's agreed to fast-track the process, but the US is worried entry could cause Russia to prolong the war. Our Europe correspondent has been at the NATO summit in Vilnius, Lithuania.
A rock star welcome for the man of the moment. Shouts of glory to Ukraine on the streets of Lithuania.
Thanks, Lithuania. Thank you very much.
But President Zelensky's welcome to the NATO summit tomorrow is likely to be more restrained. He called it absurd and weak for not giving a clear timeframe for Ukraine's membership of the alliance and said the uncertainty gives Russia motivation to continue its terror. The 31 member states met today, including Finland for the first time, agreeing to fast forward Ukraine's membership bid and create a special NATO-Ukraine council.
We also made clear that we will issue an invitation for Ukraine to join NATO when allies agree and conditions are met. This is a strong package for Ukraine and a clear path towards its membership in NATO.
This agreement Ukraine can't join while Russia's invasion continues, but the US and the likes of Germany are worried automatic membership immediately after the war could give Vladimir Putin an incentive to drag out the fighting.
As the president made clear, there is an important reason why they are not becoming a member of NATO right now, because it would instantly put the United States in a shooting war with Russia.
Currently, we're 800 kilometres away from Moscow and only 590 away from Kiev. To give you a bit of context, that's closer than the distance between Wellington and Auckland. And given all the world leaders in town, this is a major security operation.
Our Prime Minister, Chris Hipkins, meeting at least six of those world leaders today.
New Zealand has a role to play in these conversations. We've always been seen, I guess, as an honest broker and as an important partner in these conversations.
And while China's influence in the Indo-Pacific was also discussed, it is very clear from almost everywhere you look, the war in Ukraine is the main thing on everyone's mind.
So, all eyes on President Zelensky, May. What can we expect of the summit today?
Good evening. Yes, it's a big day for Ukraine and its leader, Volodymyr Zelensky, who is due here at NATO in about half an hour, where he'll meet those leaders that have been providing all the money and all the weaponry for them to fight Russia. We did have some military packages announcements at NATO on day one, but we can expect more of that when Volodymyr Zelensky meets these countries one by one. There'll be more tailored packages, including from New Zealand, where we will also meet with Volodymyr Zelensky. Chris Hipkins saying that we can expect that as the war continues, so too will New Zealand's response to it. But NATO has a juggling act here. It needs to balance Ukraine's expectations, but also avoid an escalation of the war, all while appearing like a united military alliance.
Kia ora, May. In Lithuania, May Heron.